On the left-hand side, I created a test set with some 206 samples and simulated p-values. The first thing we are going to do is to sort these p-values in ascending order. Next, we are going to assign a rank to each sample starting from 1. I'm just going to roll it down. By definition, the Q value is given by its corresponding P value times the total number of samples divided by the rank of the corresponding sample. Let's call it a theoretical Q value. However, in practice, the Q value we report deviates somehow from this definition. It is a smaller one between its theoretical Q value and the Q value from a lower term. Let's call it a practical Q value for now. To calculate it in Excel, you have to type 1 at the bottom right corner, which is one row below is the data frame. Then input the formula for the practical Q value at this cell. So take your time. Sample size divided by the rank, and then we are going to compare it with the lower term Q value. So here you go. To apply this formula to the entire column, we just have to drag it onto the top. Now, congratulations, you have the Q values. So before you leave, let's revise what we have done so far. So the first thing we do is to sort p values. The second thing is to assign rank to p values. The third thing, as you remember, we type 1 at the bottom right corner. And lastly, apply the formula of the practical Q value.